Good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Yamin Khan is joining us today. Mo from Open, Orphan, a warm welcome back. And today we're discussing your full year results that were just published to the market. These are your annual results for 2021. So a record year. Tell us more.
Yeah, thank you for having me on. Absolutely. Very pleased to announce our 2021 annual results just now. So they've shown that we have a record revenue, a 76% increase year on year. So our revenue for 2021 is £39 million, which is great to see. But on top of that, we've been able to show our first time in the history of Open Orphan a positive EBITDA, a turnaround of over £9 million. So from a 6.1 million loss last year to a 2.9 million EBITDA profitable this year. So both on the revenue side and the EBITDA, the company has shown a huge improvement. And considering the loss-making history, I think we are now on a good trend. We expect to show a higher revenue from 21 to 22 and also a positive EBITDA this year. So all in all, very happy to announce these excellent results, and we will continue to build on that and hopefully announce even better results at the end of this year.
Okay, so better to come. We like the sound of that. So let's maybe dig a bit deeper now with you, because operationally 2021 was a busy year. We caught up a few times actually on some key events, some significant growth for you. Tell us more in detail if you would.
Yes, you're absolutely right. So we had some huge milestones. We ran the first ever COVID challenge trial. We won a number of influenza and RSV clinical trials. We were able to get repeat business from four of the top 10 big pharma clients. We've also worked with a number of smaller biotechs. I think one of the key differences that we have shown that the challenge studies are now becoming more mainstream. The regulatory authorities, including the FDA, has shown the benefits of conducting challenge studies and the data from challenge studies being used by our customers to get FDA breakthrough status, shorten their regulatory timelines to marketing authorization. The number of inquiries we are getting in influenza and RSV are ever increasing. So we expect to continue to build on this, as I mentioned earlier, but the challenge studies are definitely becoming more mainstream. And again, I think with the number of studies we've run, the number of healthy volunteers we've inoculated and the portfolio of challenge models we have, we've again shown that we are the number one CRO in this field.
Okay, let's maybe look at 2022 and just sort of see, because we've already seen facilities and services expanding, as you've explained. And just last week, of course, was a big moment for you because it was the largest contract ever signed by you as a firm. How are things shaping up this year generally and crucially beyond?
So they're shaping in a really good manner. In fact, I think we are in the best shape we have ever been. So we have over 60 million pounds of signed backlog going forward. And that revenue will be recognized over this year and next year as well. So that is a really kind of a good, healthy position to be in. Our cash position remains great. We've done, as you mentioned, the signings of a number of influenza and RSV trial, including our biggest contract, but that included full service, which is something I think is also a first. So we did the drug manufacturing, we will be doing the characterization, and then also the full challenge study. We've also been awarded our first ever site study, again, a new revenue stream for us. We moved into new facilities. We've expanded our screening capacity. We've added a new screening facility in Manchester. So all in all, I think the outlook remains very strong. As I mentioned earlier, we're looking to recognize around £50 million of revenue this year, again, and also show a positive EBITDA. So from year on year, it will continue to improve. But you know, today really is about our performance in 2021, and I want to thank the whole team in great work they've done in difficult conditions sometimes with the pandemic. So I think, you know, without their commitment and effort, we wouldn't have been able to achieve this. But we're not resting on our laurels. You know, 2021 was a good year, and we are hoping to make 2022 a great year.
All right, a great year ahead. We like the sound of that, Mo. Thank you very much indeed. The Chief Executive Officer there from Open Orphan.
Thank you very much.